everyone. Today we are going to do theories of coordination compounds. There are five theories of coordination compounds, namely Werner's coordination theory, valence bond theory called VBT, crystal field theory CFT, ligand field theory LFT, molecular orbital theory MOT. We are going to do all these five theories in detail, but in this video we will be doing Werner's coordination theory only. Werner's coordination theory. As the name is Werner's, that means the theory is given by Werner. Werner gave his theory by working on a coordination compound which is called Tessard's compound, that is COCl3.6-ammonia. The postulates of this theory are, number one, a metal atom exhibits two type of valencies, that is primary valency and secondary valency. Let us see what do we mean by primary and secondary valency. This question is very important for competition as well as board's point of view. Okay, let us do it in a different form. The primary valency is also called oxidation state. That is, in the present context, it is called oxidation state, while the secondary valency is called coordination number. Primary valency is satisfied by negative or positive ligands or ions, whereas secondary valency is satisfied by ionic species as well as neutral molecules. Primary valency is a part of ionization sphere and hence it is called ionizable valency. Secondary valency is not a part of ionization sphere, but it is a part of coordination sphere, hence it is called non-ionizable valency. Primary valency forms ionic bonds with metals, whereas secondary valency forms dative bonds with metals. Primary valency is represented by dotted lines. We will show it in the structure when we will do it further. Secondary valency is represented by solid lines. Primary valency is non-directional in nature, whereas secondary valency is directional in nature, and hence it is responsible for the shape or geometry of the molecule. So we were doing the postulates and we explained that a metal atom has two valencies, primary and secondary. The second postulate is a metal atom has to satisfy both, that is primary and secondary valency, in order to form a stable coordination compound. The third postulate is, sometimes a negative ion may satisfy both primary as well as secondary valency. In such cases, it is represented by both dotted and solid lines. So you all might be thinking, how can we represent primary and secondary valency by dotted and solid lines? Let me show you. We are going to represent these two valencies in Tessard's compound, the compound which we have read just in the beginning. Now we are going to represent the primary and secondary valency of this compound, that is Tessard's compound, which is COCl3.6-ammonia, which has a valency +3 and coordination number equal to 6. Now CO(ammonia)6Cl3, the valency of cobalt here is X plus 0 minus 3 is equal to 0, that is X is equal to +3. Cobalt is in the middle and 6 ammonia are surrounding cobalt, that is they are coordinated with cobalt with dative bond. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ammonia and 6 dative bonds are there, and the chlorides are represented by dotted lines, that means they represent the primary valencies, not the secondary valencies. Primary valencies are those which are outside the coordination sphere, and secondary are those which are inside the coordination sphere. Now let's have a look over the second type of Tessard's compound. As I have told you that they are represented by four types of compounds. Okay, the second is when we have 5 ammonia inside the coordination sphere and 1 chloride inside the coordination sphere, and 2 chlorides are outside the coordination sphere. So as we have 5 ammonia, so we can draw 5 dative bonds of ammonia here. Alright, also we can see there is 1 chloride ion inside the coordination sphere, so this dative bond is fulfilled by this chloride ion. Now the primary valencies, the first one by this chloride ion, the second one also by the chloride ion outside the coordination sphere, and the third one, this primary valency, is also this chloride also fulfills the primary valency as well as the secondary valency here. Alright, so this chloride ion represents both secondary and primary valencies. That's why we have drawn both dotted as well as solid lines. So this is our third type of compound. As you can see from the previous compound that we are adding one chlorine inside and removing one ammonia outside. Inside. That means a chlorine is reduced from outside, a chlorine is increased inside, and ammonia is reduced inside. Alright, now let us draw this cobalt. Now we have to draw four ammonia. Let us draw it evenly. That is one here, second here, this ammonia here, and the fourth one here. We can draw it anywhere, but to form symmetry, we are drawing it here. Now the chlorine one and two. Alright, now let us fulfill the primary valencies. Number one by this chlorine. Rest two valencies are covered by these two. So we will draw both solid and dotted lines in this. So our fourth compound is CONH3 thrice Cl3. From the previous compound, you can see that we have added one chlorine inside. Now there are no chlorines left outside, and one ammonia is also removed from here. Alright, let's complete the structure. We have three ammonia, one, two, and three. We have three chlorine ions inside, one, two, three. Now primary valency, that is primary valency also covered by these three chlorines, one, two, and three. So from these compounds, you can see that chlorine represents the primary valency here. That means it fulfills the valency. Primary valency means valency or the oxidation state as we have done, and secondary valency means the coordination number. So here coordination number is 6. That means inside the coordination sphere we have 6 ligands attached to this cobalt, and the valency is plus 3. Valency of cobalt is plus 3. That means minus 1 minus 2, x is equal to 0. That means x is equal to plus 3. Alright, so chlorine here fulfills primary as well as secondary valency. That's why we have represented it by both dotted as well as solid line. Okay, so in all these compounds, this particular method is used. To distinguish between these four compounds which we have done, one can take the help of primary valencies. Okay, in the first compound, okay, you can firstly see all the four compounds together. In the first compound, there were three chloride ions formed, because these the ions which are outside the coordination sphere will give the ions when in aqueous form. Okay, so this compound gives three chloride ions, this will give two chloride ions, one chloride ions, and this will give no chloride ion. Alright, so here valency plus 3 of coordination sphere, plus 2, plus 1, and 0. Okay, now when this compound is treated with silver nitrate AgNO3, it will give 3 mole AgCl, because this chloride ion, these 3 chloride ions will react with silver nitrate to form AgCl, 3 mole AgCl. And in conductance test, we will get I is equal to 4. I means number of ions formed, that is 3 plus 1, 4. Alright, so its molar conductance will be very high. Similarly, in the second compound, 2 chloride ions, so in silver nitrate test, they will give 2 mole AgCl. And I is equal to 3, 2 plus 1, 3, and conductance will be quite lesser than this one. In the third, the valency is plus 1, minus 1 mole AgCl, ions formed 2, 1 plus 1, 2, and conductance is very low. In the third compound, no ions are formed, so silver nitrate test will give no results. I is 0 here, and molar conductance is equivalent to 0. Next come the limitations of theory. This theory, that is Werner's theory, cannot tell that why only certain metals can form coordination compounds. It cannot explain the optical and magnetic properties of the complexes, and it cannot explain the absorption spectra of coordination compounds. So the second theory, that is VBT, came into existence, and now in the next video we will be learning about valence bond theory in detail. So thanks for watching the video. Bye bye.